This Christmas, meet four children from Glasgow and join them in their discovery of a magic wee hing.
Welcome, children.
What the fuck is that?
Children, children, what do you ask of me? A Christmas wish?
You do wishes.
Young sir, I do. Name your heart's desire, and with a sprinkle of moonbeams, I shall make your fondest dream come true.
Make your next-door neighbour have a black baby.
Well, I've got money on Celtic for the cup. Make Rangers fucking blind.
Just do it, you fucking wee dick. Dead leg.
You shattered my hip. Oh, God. Please, no. I could make your toys come to life for an evening.
Shag this rabbit.
Children, please. My apologies, Mrs. Rabbit. No. The shame.
Yes.
Children, please. No. No, please, children, no. Thank you, Lucy. You're very kind.
Just trying to make sure you're better. I bet my Christmas money you'll be able to fight off this dog.
Hey, Jesus Christ! That's shit!
Get the fuck off me!
Get off me! No! No! My face! My face!
This Christmas, experience the wonder of the magic wee hing.
I'm Ian McCulloch from Echo and the Bunnymen. I now present a sort of Twilight Zone show of little moral fables. It's called Within the Centaur's Eye. This is a tale I was going to call Rich Man, Poor Man, but I changed it to the story of the incredibly horrible thing that happened to Alexander Hillman. Then I changed my mind and I changed it back again. It's still not quite right. Here's tonight's tale. From within the centaur's eye.
Come, come in my eye.
Everyone else is wandering about with everything they want. Clothes, cars, phones, happiness. This guy outside's got a bus.
Well, he's a bus driver.
I don't even have a girlfriend.
I'm your girlfriend.
You're just someone I watch TV with. We don't even have a TV.
You are an asshole.
Shit. And I don't even have her. She was nothing. And I've got less than nothing.
As Alexander Hillman found out that he had less than nothing, he was also about to find out.
I'd give anything just to have something.
And it does not take much to wake the devil.
Pleasure to meet you. I'm no flim-flam artist, Mr. Nelson. I'm a businessman. I don't seek to bamboozle you. I seek to make a deal. Now, can I help you? Well, that rather depends on what you want and, of course, what you can give. Now, what is it that you want? Is it goods? Yes. Televisions and tumble dryers and televisions? Yes. Is that what you want?
Everybody else's life just seems so full and mine, it's just not how I imagined it would be.
How would you imagine it to be?
Better?
Well, then I wouldn't be any kind of man at all if I didn't help you. There is a little outlay on your part. Your pinky fingers.
You may as well.
Shaka.
No, I don't even have any pinkies.
Yes, but all you can imagine will be yours.
He doesn't even like pinkies.
The darkness consumed him, but it was not death. It was a sweet, sweet slumber from which he awoke with an abounding vitality and found that his nothing had become something, and it was everything he thought it could be. For Alexander Hillman, the world was at last just as he imagined. His riches...
Try this one.
His influence.
Cindy Barbana.
An extraordinary life. Where each moment shone with possibility.
Oh, it's warm. So warm. It's warm.
The moral? Perhaps we should all be more careful about what deals we make. Maybe if you find a time during the outbreak, you could phone the police. Bring on the dancing horses, wherever they may roam. Bring on the dancing horses, wherever they may roam. Bring on the dancing horses.
Tell me what you know about the arms shipment.
I'll be telling you nothing, freak.
Unfortunately for you, my lasso of truth means you can't help being completely honest. Now, tell me.
I really like to fuck you, Wonder Woman. I really like to fuck your tits. Nothing I tells you.
Oh, I'd fuck you so hard, Wonder Woman. Your gynecologist would think you'd been in a car accident.
Tell me about the arms shipment.
I really don't know anything about it.
Wow. You're the first guy I've met in weeks that doesn't just want to fuck me. Want to go for a drink?
Wonder Woman, I'm here to warn you about the road you're on. Giving hand jobs for information. Batman and I have both found that it can be a slippery slope.
This is definitely the last information I'm giving you.
Great Scott! I seem to have hit a Boeing 747.
Join us after the break with news of Superman saving a passenger aircraft with a golden lasso tied around his balls.
Cookie! We want cookie!
I'm not a cookie!
You're wrong, baby!
What's that? The worst thing I've ever done? Lindsay Lohan.
What me name, bitch?
Cookie Monster!
No, 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 no. Me the fucking Pussy Monster. Cookie!
Sharon Stone. If you looked at her now, you'd say that she wasn't worth the sweat it'd take to rape her. Back in the day, she was something else. If you stop Basic Instinct at 9 minutes 32, she's standing on the stairs. And if you look very carefully, you can see my cum flying past her ear.
Just like that, baby. Just like that. Go kill.
Robin Atkins made his name in the British sex comedies of the 1970s. But gradually the work dried up, partly because cinema going fell into general decline, and partly because changing attitudes meant that people started to view his character as a serial sex offender. Undaunted, he made his way to Los Angeles and tried his hand on the American pornographic scene.
I want you in my ass.
Hey, what the fuck?
Blimey, it's your husband. I guess I better get going, eh?
You go nowhere, buddy.
No, I want him in my ass.
You heard the lady. Milk motherfucker.
Yeah, baby. Yeah. Yeah. You like that?
Yeah.
Hey, make some room. Robin did a lot of US work in the 80s, but never really seemed to fit in.
That's it. Oh, keep going.
In fact, he became somewhat disillusioned with the work. And when the chance came to relocate to Germany, he had high hopes of getting back to what he did best. But times had moved on.
Robin Atkins, who died today from AIDS.